Because in India, we are not very much aware about this term that is called as industrial hygiene. This term is basically come from the American institutes, and that is why the definition is also from the AIHA, that is American Industrial Hygiene Association. So from AIHA, industrial hygiene is defined as that science and art devoted to the anticipation, recognition, evaluation and control of those environmental factors of stresses. So the main focus is on the anticipation, recognition, evaluation and control. So these are the main 4 points, that is nothing but identification, acceptance, measurement and assessment, and the control on the environmental factors of stresses. So generally, that is heat, cold, humidity, etc. are the examples of these environmental factors of stresses. So we have to identify, we have to accept some of the limits for the particular level, and then we have to measure, then we have to assess some chemical analysis or some other techniques we can adopt for the evaluation and assessment, and then we must think of how to control these activities or the environmental factors of stresses, right? So these are nothing but the industrial hygiene concept. So from this arising in or from the workplace, which may cause sickness, impaired health and well-being, or significant discomfort and inefficiency among workers or among the citizens of this community. So this is basically, we can define the industrial hygiene from the AIHA. So these are the main points. These are anticipation, recognition, evaluation and control of the environmental factors or stresses. Now generally, when we are talking about the environmental factors or stresses, the main points are physical hazards, biological hazards, ergonomic hazards, psychological hazards and chemical hazards. So we have already discussed about these physical, biological, ergonomic, psychological and chemical hazards. Normally when we are talking about the cuts, wounds, sharp edges, etc., they are under physical hazards. When we are talking about some diseases or bacterias or viruses, all these are under biological hazards. When we are talking about the backache or forearm ache or some other issues which is related to our body or body parts, that is ergonomic hazards. Then some psychological hazards, that may be a tension, and that due to the personal factors, that may be your stresses or overload conditions in the industries, that is psychological hazards. And when we are talking about the chemical hazards, we will discuss the chemical hazards in details in this presentations, especially when we are talking about the toxic chemical, hazardous chemicals, etc. So we are not going to consider a specific mechanical, electrical or fire hazards in this presentation, because all these hazards are very much concerned with the accidents, injuries or the property damage than the industrial hygiene or occupation health. So these are the main environmental factors or stresses which are going to control under the industrial hygiene concept. So these are the different techniques under the controlling techniques or controlling measures, or it is also called as controlling methods. So under these controlling methods of different environmental factors or stresses, the main control measures are environmental, technical control measures, then personal and medical control measures, then administrative control measures. So under environmental technical control measures, there are different points like design and layout, then elimination at source. Elimination means removal. So removal of that particular stress, that is environmental factor or stress, from that source itself. The methods may be adopt for the elimination technique is substitution, modification in process, or equipment maintenance. Then, in continuation with these environmental technical control measures, design and layout should be thought of to avoid the environmental stresses. Then elimination at source with the help of substitution, modification in process or equipment maintenance. Then isolation, closed systems, enclosures, separating walls, distance, time, etc. So we can isolate these sources where from these environmental factors or stresses can be developed. Then ventilation is one of the technique to control these environmental factors from the technical point of view. So we have to calculate the air requirement in that particular environment or in the working area where these environmental factors can be available in that working environment. So we have to ventilate that particular area. So local exhaust ventilation is one of the technique. Then dilution is another technique under the ventilation. Then wet method, that is we can spray the water in that area to settle the dust or particulate matters. That is called as wet methods. Then good housekeeping, storage and labeling. These are the different techniques to control the environmental factors or stresses with the help of environmental technical control measures. Now another control measure is personal and medical control measures. So under that, work practices, medical examination, first aid techniques, personal protective equipment, reduction of exposure time or rotation, and personal hygiene. So we can adopt these good practices which is directly related to the medical issues or to the personal factors. So if you go for the rotation technique or if you go for the reduction of the exposure time, so obviously the adverse health effect is going to reduce. If you go for the frequent medical examination, then we can understand where exactly the environmental factors are repaired or created and what are the health effects on this. If you go for the first aid techniques, then we can reduce the long-term effects or adverse effect on our health. If you go for the adopting the personal protective equipments, that may be a respiratory type or non-respiratory type, then obviously the effect can be minimized. So these are under the personal and medical control measures. Then administrative control measure is another control measure. Under that, we can go for the education and training, then walkthrough survey, inspection and monitoring, industrial hygiene audit, safety audit, and environmental audits. So with the help of these audits, indirectly, we can go for the inspections, observations frequently, and specifically for the special area where these environmental factors or stresses are more. So we can go for the different types of training, specific training. Suppose there is a chemical hazards or possibility of chemical attack on your body, then we must go through the trainings of chemical hazards, how to tackle, how to handle these types of toxic chemicals or hazardous chemicals, how to reduce the exposure time in that working environment where the chemical fumes or dust or mist, smog may be present. So these are the different techniques under these administrative control measures. So these are the different controlling measures or controlling methods to control the environmental factors or stresses. So this chart gives you a overview of all the controlling measures. Now we will discuss one by one in detail. So what exactly the hierarchy should be for controlling all these types of working environmental factors or stresses with the help of the discussed techniques. So the hierarchy should be elimination, then substitution, then containment, then local exhaust ventilation, general ventilation, then administrative control, and then personal protective equipment. And the priority is shown in this diagram. So we must go for the elimination, that is removal of that particular stress or environmental factor or that particular hazard. That is first priority. If that can't be eliminated or it is not feasible to eliminate these techniques, these process, these hazards or the stresses, then we must adopt the substitution method. Means a particular substance or a particular process or a particular parameter should be substituted by the less adverse effective parameters or the substances or the process. If again the elimination as well as substitution is not feasible, then we must go for the containment or LEV or general dilution or ventilation technique, that is also called as engineering control. And if all these techniques are not feasible, then and then only we must go for the administrative control as well as for the personal protective equipments. So from this hierarchy we can understand PPE are the last resort for controlling these environmental factors or stresses. So what exactly elimination? Does the process step or task have to be done? Turn down the temperature. Lower temperature means less vapor given off. So if we can reduce the temperature, if we can eliminate the temperature or we can control the temperature at the room temperature, then obviously we can control the vapors of that particular chemical in that environment. That is the simple example of the elimination. Substitution, the change form of material, that is one of the aspect, that is dust for granular pellet. Then change one solvent for one of lower volatile. So more volatile component are substituted by the less volatile component. That is one of the solution. Then water-based products and not solvent-based products. So some paints, pigments, etc. There are various chemicals which are water-based as well as solvent-based. So we can go for water-based products instead of solvent-based, because in solvents, the more volatile components or chemicals are involved, and these chemicals are again vaporized or evaporated in that working environment, which can affect on our health. Use glues and oils without sensitizers or carcinogens. So the substances which can cause cancer can be substituted by the non-carcinogenic substances. That is another example of substitution. Then engineering control. So totally enclosed system is one of the important and commonly adopted technique as engineering control. So if you enclose all the process, a total process, including all the equipments and the conveyor systems, etc., then indirectly we can control all these fumes, dust, MVC, LVC, etc. in the working environment. Then reduce generated source emissions. So whatever the emission, that may be in terms of air emission, that may be in the terms of liquid emissions. So that emissions or the quantity of that emission can be reduced with the help of engineering control. So by avoiding leakages, by substituting or replacing the gaskets frequently, or by adopting more accurate valves or the automated system instead of the conventional systems. Then containment of these facilities or the plants, that is another engineering control. Then reduction or elimination of need of for the maintenance staff in that area. So we can reduce that particular number of staff, we can reduce the maintenance activities, we can reduce some of the activities by adopting the robotics techniques, by adopting the artificial intelligence or some latest technological development in our area. Then limit area contaminated. If spills or leaks. So if your process is having some of the chemicals or with the help of some flow rates, some concentrations, with the help of some pipelines, reactors, vessels, etc. If there are chances of spills or leakages, then we have to limit that contaminated area, or we can isolate that spillage area from other area of the industries. Then LEV, that is one of the technique. If we know the area where the fumes, dust or the volatile substances can be generated in that working environment, then we can use this LEV technique to absorb these fumes or dust or volatile substances like VOC, that is volatile organic carbon, or some more volatile components from that area with the help of absorption or scrubbing technique, that is called as LEV. We can adopt this technique, or we can also go for the dilution as a ventilation technique. Then this dilution is nothing but the ventilation techniques, means we are feeding more and more air in that area to reduce the concentration of that particular substance or chemical. So these are the different kinds of engineering controls. Then administrative controls, we have to reduce the number of persons, that is administrative control. We can reduce the level and duration of exposure. So we can go for the rotation, we can go for the different time of exposure or level of exposure. Suppose if the 30 minutes exposure is there, then we can try to reduce the exposure from 30 to 20 or 15 minutes. Then quantities of substances used or produced. Whatever the quantities of substances are there, we can try to reduce the quantity of that chemical, or we can try to substitute that substance. Then another administrative controls are work practices changes. Examples, vacuum versus sweeping. So likewise, by studying the engineering concepts or mechanism, we can go for the work practice change. So we have already discussed about the technological change like robotics, artificial intelligence, or vacuum based operations instead of the mechanical based operation, etc. We can reduce the environmental stresses. Then regular cleaning of surfaces, that is one of the area where if we are going to clean all the surfaces, then obviously these chemicals which are present on the surfaces are also clean. So if the temperature is increased, or if some other environmental factors are changed, and due to that environmental factors or due to the temperature, if there are chances of liquid to vapor conversion from that chemicals which is available on the surfaces, that are going to reduce due to this cleaning technique. Then safe chemical storage and waste disposal. So whatever the toxic and hazardous chemicals are there, we can store it in a proper manner. Even we should be more serious about these toxic and hazardous chemical while storing and while handling these waste for the disposal techniques. Then hygiene arrangement or facilities for washing, storage of PPEs, arrangements for laundering, etc. should be available in that industry where all these types of chemicals are available, or some hazardous and toxic chemicals can be handled or stored in that industry. Then we can go for the prohibition of eating, drinking and smoking. That is one of the administrative control, and training is another administrative control. So if the new employees are there, or if the employees are transferred from one department to another department, or as a refresher course also, we have to adopt these types of training, how to control the spillage, how to control the leakage, how to control the exposure time, how to reduce the waste, how to reduce the chemical utilizations, or some other techniques. So we must go through the different types of training to reduce the adverse effects of these environmental stresses. Then last resort is PP. If all these techniques are not feasible or not economical in your industry, then we must go for the PPs. So engineering or admin control are being installed or implemented, then we must go for the PPs also. So PPs may be a gas mask or SCBA, self-contained breathing apparatus, or some hood arrangements, etc., to avoid the respiration. If you want to avoid the contamination, if you want to avoid the contamination on the shirts, pants, hairs, etc., then we must go for the full body apron. Then we can also avoid these types of vapors, fumes from the inhalation. Then we must go for the respiratory type of PP. So depending on the condition, we must select appropriate PP, and also we must maintain all these PPs. We must go for the inspection and testing techniques of these PPs also. Now we have discussed about the different controlling techniques for the environmental stresses as far as the controlling methods are concerned. Then hierarchy are concerned. Now these are the three levels how you control these environmental stresses. So from these three levels we can also control these environmental stresses. The three levels are at source, then at air path, and at receiver. So these are the three levels where we can control the environmental stresses. The methods may be similar or repetitive under these three levels. Like for example, substitution. So we have already discussed about this substitution. So this substitution technique is under the at source level. So at source itself, if it is possible to substitute that particular chemical component, then we must adopt that technique. So for example, toluene in place of benzene, silicon carbide in place of silica in grinding stone, or water in place of solvent. So this is the substitution technique under the controlling method, and which is under at source level. Then change of process or technology. So airless paint spraying is one of the example of technological change. We have already discussed about the robotics is the main technological change in the paint department. Then robotics is another example for the pressing mechanism or punching press mechanism. Then there are lots of example nowadays in technological changes. Enclosure of process, that is covering, we already discussed. Isolation by space or by time means we can isolate the areas where these chemicals or some environmental stresses are present. Then we can isolate with the partition, that is physical partition, or we can isolate these things with the help of a reduction of exposure time. Then wet methods, that is water spraying, especially it is used for the controlling the dust or particulate matter. Then LEV, we have already discussed, that is capturing at the source. So we can absorb or scrub these chemicals at a particular point. Then waste disposal, that is under the pollution control techniques, and the guidelines are given by the State Pollution Control Board. And good maintenance is one of the technique which is under the at source classification of these control measures. Then at air path, increasing natural ventilation. So we have already discussed about the general ventilation or feeding the quantity of air in that working environment, that is called as ventilation. If the feeding of air by opening the window, by using the turbine, then it is called as natural ventilation. If you are going to add the fans, blower, etc., that is external agency, then the ventilation is called as artificial ventilation. Then these fans, that is nothing but the artificial ventilation. So we can use also the exhaust ventilations, means for removal of these chemicals, fumes, gases, etc., we can use this exhaust ventilation. And for adding the air, we can use these fans or blower. So the fans and the mechanisms are same, but the application may be same. That is positive force or positive pressure, and second one is negative pressure, that is exhaust. Sometimes we have to use this positive as well as negative pressure in that area. Increasing distance between the source and the receiver, that is semi-automatic or remote control, that is also one of the technique under air path control. Then dilution or mechanical ventilations, we already discussed. Continuous area monitoring, that is preset alarms can be set in that area where we know that these types of chemicals can be generated in the working environment or can be respired by the persons. Then good housekeeping and good maintenance are one of the general points under at air path as well as at source. Then third level of controlling measures is at receiver. So if it is not possible to control it at source, if it is not possible to control at air path, then we have to control it at receiver. Personal hygiene methods like washing, bathing, good diet methods, no smoking provisions, no intoxication, etc. So nowadays, if you are touching your hands on table surface, on chair surface, on lift surface, or some other surface where we can't avoid these things for the daily routine. So the last point is, that is at receiver end. So we can wash our hands, we can take a full bath, or we can go for a good diet, etc. These are some of the examples even in the COVID-19 situation, that is in the pandemic situations. So that is called as at receiver level personal hygiene methods. Then you can go for the use of PPEs, and you can go for the good maintenance practices. Then use of protective cream or lotion, so to avoid the chemicals entering through the skin, we can go for the protective cream or lotion. Then dosimeter is one of the device. We can measure the noise at that level. And especially when we are talking about the noise level at a personal level, then we must use these dosimeters. Especially it is designed for the 8 hours criteria, that is time weighted average as per as the state rules as well as central acts are concerned. So nowadays this criteria is become stringent from 90 decibels to 85 decibels. So we must measure this sound level in our working environment. Enclosure of worker, that is AC cabin, is can be adopted for reducing the temperature. For if you are going to reduce the temperature, so obviously the more volatile components, volatile organic carbons, can be controlled due to the less temperature. Then rotation of workers, so I have already discussed, especially when we are talking about the foundry conditions, when we are talking about the furnace, when we are talking about the boiler operations, etc., where the temperature is more, then we must adopt the rotation techniques to reduce the exposure time. Then training and education, that is one of the administrative control we have already discussed. Medical examination and follow-up. So pre-medical examination, during medical and post-medical examination, these are the general practices. But when we are talking about the specific toxic chemicals, then hazardous chemicals, then we must go for the frequent medical examination to check whether these chemicals are exceed in our body or not, because there are some maximum permissible limits, that is guidelines are given by the government, and that should be controlled by that industry. The control measures like technological change can be also be classified as under, that is engineering control, and under the engineering control we have already discussed about the substitution and modification technique. So some of the examples of these substitutions are like mercury compounds may be replaced by the mercury free materials, then leaded glaze paint pigments can be substituted by the leadless glaze paint and pigments, then benzene can be replaced by the cyclohexane or certain ketones, then CCl4 can be replaced by methyl chloroform, dichloromethane, etc. And there are lots of chemicals which can be substituted by another chemicals, but depending on our requirement and the physical and chemical characteristics of that substances. Then these are the examples of the modifications. So covered containers can be modified as open containers. Some mechanical gauges can be used instead of the mercury gauges. Then mechanical pump seals can be used instead of the gasket pump seals. Then airless spray can be used instead of hand spraying techniques, etc. So all these techniques are the modification techniques. The modification may be in the instrument, in the equipment, or in the process itself to avoid the environmental stresses. Then there are other methods like isolations, enclosure of process, segregation, etc. So we already discussed whatever the air path, the air source, or the end of that particular chemical product can be enclosed by a covering material. And if you are going to cover these systems by the barrier walls, by the cabins, or the isolations by the distance or time, then the adverse effect of these environmental factors can be reduced. If you are going to segregate or separate out all these chemical factors or the environmental stresses, then also you can reduce the effect of these chemicals. Then we already talked about this ventilation technique. That may be a general ventilation, that may be a local ventilation, that may be a natural ventilation, that may be a artificial ventilation, etc. So especially when we are talking about the volatile chemicals, then ventilation should be adopted. Especially when we are talking about the dust, then we should go for the water spraying method, and it is also called as wet process. And if in the environment, in the working environment, if some active chemicals are there, like if acid fumes are there, then we have to neutralize these acid fumes by the base. And if the bases are more, then we have to neutralize it by acid. Likewise, you have to identify the characteristics of that chemicals, and we can adopt the neutralization technique also. Then housekeeping, good maintenance, and sampling and monitoring is also one of the measurement to control these types of techniques. So in one of the presentation, we already discussed about these air sampling methods, water sampling methods. Then under the air sampling methods also, we have already discussed about the personal sampler techniques or the high volume sampler techniques and different monitoring techniques. So we will not discuss all these sampling and monitoring measures here. Some of the important controlling method, that is especially when we are talking about the air pollutants, especially when we are talking about the dust, when we are talking about the suspended particulate matter or respirable suspended particulate matter, then we must adopt the different controlling technique, that is air pollution controlling technique, like ventilation systems, then inertia devices like cyclone separator, centrifugal collector, multiple cyclones, then electrostatic precipitators, then particulate scrubbers like cyclone scrubbers, venturi scrubbers, spray chambers, then filters like back filter, pack filter, filter bed, absorption devices like gas scrubber, absorption towers, then adsorption, AD, so that is surface phenomena, then fixed bed adsorber, moving bed adsorber, etc. Then combustion device like combustion chambers, flare, incinerator, catalytic combustion chambers, afterburners, then condensation device like direct contact condenser, surface heat exchanger should be adopted to control these air pollutants, because these are nothing but the parts of environmental stresses or environmental factors. So there are also some legal requirement for this air pollution in the Factory Act as well as the Air Pollution Control Act. So under the Factory Act, Section 41A, with reference to the Site Appraisal Committee, all these guidelines are given, and for more detail, the Air Pollution Control Act is given. So there are other methods are also, or the systems are can be adopted for these air pollution control or air pollutant control, like gas solid absorption, thermal decomposition systems, settling chambers, filtration techniques, and using more heated chimneys, etc. Thermal incineration is one of the commonest technique which is adopted in India for controlling these air pollutants, especially when we are talking about the hydrocarbons. So if the hydrocarbons are present in the working environment, or the toxic chemicals or some noxious materials are present in the environment, then we have to incinerate it or we have to burn it, and after burning these gases, it is called as flue gases, may generally contain carbon monoxide, water vapor, and inert gases. So, but depending upon the residues being incinerated, it may also contain acidic gases like halides and their acid oxides of phosphorus, sulfur, nitrogen, and entrained salts of metals. So depending on the type of industry, depending on the processes, all these chemicals can be contaminated in that air, and on the basis of these air contaminants, we have to adopt the thermal incineration as one of the air pollution controlling method. So incineration process can be employed to burn solids, liquids, or gases waste. Some such processes are given below, like incineration process in the rotary kiln, that is temperature about 820 to 1600 degrees Celsius, and the residence time for the liquid gases in seconds, and for the solids it may be in hours. Then liquid injection techniques, 650 to 1600 degrees Celsius, and the residence time is from 0.1 to 2 seconds. Likewise for fluidized bed, multiple heart, co-incineration, star wear, and some other combustion techniques can be adopted to control these air pollutants. Then there are other devices which are commonly used to control these air pollution. That is Venturi scrubber, that is for the 6 to 20 inch mg range, or 20 to 6 inches mg range for the low pressure loss units, and for the sticky material or the material which can't be incinerated or can't be burned directly into the incineration, that can be scrubbed or absorbed by the Venturi scrubber itself. Then the personal and medical control is another controlling measure which is shown in the chart. So pre-placement medical examination, that is one of the good practice. So before starting the actual work in the industry, we must go for the medical examination to protect that worker against any potential harmful exposures. So example, worker affected by a pulmonary tuberculosis should not be placed in exposure of silica. So if that person is already having some diseases which is related to the lungs, so that person should not expose to a particular department in that particular area where silica or chlorinated hydrocarbon atmosphere is there. So if the lung diseases are already present in that person, then that person should be isolated or should be avoided working in that area where the hydrocarbons or chlorinated hydrocarbons or silica or dust SPM are present. So that is the benefit of this pre-placement medical examination. Then next one is periodical medical examination. So after some days, after some months or at least 6 months period, there is a medical examination that is called as periodical medical examination, and the minimum requirement is annual medical examination. But when we are talking about the toxic chemicals, when we are talking about the environmental stresses or the maximum permissible limits, if in some of the area these working limits are exceeded, then we must go for the frequent medical examination to check whether what exactly the before or pre-medical examination reports are and what exactly the current medical examination report are. If there is a difference or any contamination of the chemicals in the lungs or maybe in the blood, maybe in the skin, etc., then we must go for the treatment and that person should be avoided to work in that area. Then third one is personal protective devices. So when we are talking about the gases, dust, mist, etc., then we must go for the respiratory type of PPE. If you want to avoid the contamination on our body parts, then we must go for the non-respiratory PPE like glasses, goggles, protective clothing, that may be a apron or full body apron, etc. Then if any symptoms are there or some nausea or that may be a uncomfortability to a person, then we must adopt a first aid technique and call for the doctor. So all the industries where these environmental factors or stresses are generated should be well equipped, should have the well equipped laboratories where you can test the blood, urine, stool, lungs, skin, etc. to detect onset of symptoms of health effects. Then there is another technique which is called as administrative control, which we have already discussed in detail. So there are different educations and techniques involved in these administrative controls. Some inspection techniques can be involved, that may be on the daily basis, that may be on the monthly basis, weekly basis or fortnight basis. Then some shift in charge safety report book, where you can understand what exactly the changes in the environment are or what exactly the health issues are there. Then we can adopt some other techniques to control these environmental stresses and we can reduce the health effects on the persons. Then industrial hygiene, safety and environment audits are also included in this administrative control. If all these control measures are not adequate, then we can also go for the special control measure techniques. So some special controlling measure techniques like useful for the biohazards. So biohazards exist due to some bacteria, some viruses, some fungus, etc. And we have to control all these bacteria, fungus, viruses with the help of some techniques, with the help of some test, with the help of some practices like good housekeeping, personal hygiene, laboratory safety, animal care and handling, biological safety cabinets, use of sterilization or autoclaving technique, and disinfection and precautionary measures. So we can go for a specific or special control measures depending on the type of hazards. Thank you.